Hey everyone, Kevin here. Ever been locked out of your own Excel sheet? No worries, I've got you covered. Today, we'll learn how to unprotect an Excel sheet, even without the password. Plus, we'll look at unlocking an entire workbook. Let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel, and I don't know about you, but I'm hungry for some cookies and I want to fill out this cookie order form. But when I try to do that, I get this error message telling me that this is a protected sheet. Let's click on OK, and up on the top tabs, let's click on Review. Over on the right-hand side, I see the Protect category, and I see an option to unprotect the sheet. But when I click on this, I have to type in the password, and I can't remember what the password is. Let's close out of this. So right now, this sheet, or sheet number one, or the order form, is protected. Also, I would like to add some analytics into this spreadsheet, but when I click on this plus icon, the workbook is also protected. Right up on top, I have the option to protect the workbook. When I click on this, to unprotect it, I also have to type in a password, but I don't remember what that password is. So how do we remove this protection without knowing the password? Well, next, let's press the Windows key together with E to open up File Explorer. Within File Explorer, navigate to where you have your Excel spreadsheet. Here, I see my spreadsheet titled Order Form. Before we do anything to this sheet, let's first make a copy, just to make sure we don't lose anything. This is just for safety. I'll click on this file, press Ctrl-C to copy, and Ctrl-V to paste, and there, we now have a copy of this file. Next, we need to modify the file extension of this file, but I don't see any file extensions here. First, we need to turn this on. Within File Explorer, let's click on this View dropdown, and all the way at the bottom, we have the option to Show. And here, we see the option for File Name Extensions. Let's click on that, and after both files, you should now see the .xlsx file extension. To change the file extension, let's right-click on the file, and in this context menu at the top, we can rename it. When we hover over, you'll also see that the shortcut key is F2. I'm a big fan of shortcut keys, so let's try that. I'll click on the file, press F2, and go to the very end where we have the Excel extension, and then delete that. And in place of it, let's type in .zip, then click away. This opens up a dialog asking us if we're sure we want to change it. We are, so let's click on yes. Let's now click into the zip file. This opens up all of the contents of the Excel file. And first, I want to remove the reference to the password on the worksheet. To do that, let's click into the Excel folder. Then down at the bottom, we have another folder for worksheets. I'll click on this, and here we see two separate worksheets, sheet1.xml and sheet2.xml. I had the password on sheet number one. Let's click on this file and then copy it. Press Ctrl-C. Then let's paste the copy onto the desktop by pressing Ctrl-V. Let's right-click on the file, and within this menu, go down to Open With, and let's open it with Notepad so we can make changes to this XML file. Oh boy, I don't think any of us signed up for this. This is the XML file for sheet number one. To make it easier to view, up on top, click on the View menu, and here you have the option to turn on Word Wrap. We need to find and remove the sheet protection tag from this XML file. So how do we do that? Press Ctrl F, and that opens up search, and then type in sheet protection. Then click on search. And here I see the sheet protection tag. This tag is what adds the password protection to this sheet. We need to remove this. Here we see the opening angle bracket. Start from there and then highlight it all the way until you find the closing angle bracket. Here I see the closing one. Now, one thing to call out, if you want to make changes to your sheet and then you want to re-add this exact same password, make sure you take note of this location in the XML file and then you copy this specific tag. Then you could reinsert it here later on. I don't have a need to re-add the same password, so I'm just going to delete it. I'll hit backspace and that's now gone. Up on top, let's go to the File menu, click on Save, and now we could close out of Notepad. Let's now take the XML file that we edited, and here we can drag and drop it back in. It asks us if we want to copy and replace. We do, so let's click on that. If you also want to remove password protection from the workbook, it's pretty much the same process. We just have to do it to a different file. Let's click on the Excel folder, and down at the bottom, we have workbook.xml. Let's select this file, press Ctrl-C, and then let's also paste this onto the desktop. Just like we did before, let's right-click on this file, go down to Open With, and let's open this in Notepad. Let's press Control F, and this time let's search for Workbook Protection. I'll search for that, and here we see the Workbook Protection tag. Start from the angle bracket and go all the way to the closing angle bracket. Highlight all of that. Again, if you want to re-add this later, make sure to copy it and then paste it into the exact same location in this XML file. I just want to remove it. I'll press delete, and right up on top, let's go to File, Save, and then we could close out of Notepad. Let's now drag the file that we edited back in. Here, it asks me if I want to copy and replace. I do, and that's now all set. Let's now go back to the root folder. Down below, I see my orderform.zip file. Let's now rename this to an Excel file. I'll remove the .zip extension, and let's type in xlsx, and then hit Enter. It asks me if I'm sure that I want to rename it. Let's click on Yes. This is now the moment of truth. Let's open up the Excel file by double-clicking on it. If the spreadsheet opens properly, that means you walk through all the steps correctly. But let's see if the worksheet protection has been removed. Right down below, let's see if I can type in my name. It looks like I can. Let's also see if the workbook protection has been removed. Down below, let's see if I could add a new sheet, and that also works as expected. Up on top, if we click on the Review tab, over here I can now protect the sheet if I'd like to type in a new password. And over here, if we click on Protect Workbook, I could also type in a password there. All right, there you go. Now I can finally place my cookie order. I suggest you do the same. Cookies make everything better, except on the web. If this helped you, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.